Internal erosion is one of the primary failure modes for earthen dams and levees. Earthen dams and levees in our country are critical infrastructure. They provide water storage, hydropower, flood control for much of our population.
Internal erosion is a problem because it has major safety implications for the general public. Internal erosion can lead to dam failures. That's happened many times throughout history. We've estimated that roughly 50% of dam failures are caused by internal erosion.
Detecting internal erosion is difficult. We have dams that are hundreds of feet high, thousands of feet long. It can be 2 feet below the surface, it can be 100 feet below the surface. It's just very difficult to be at the right spot at the right time.
Internal erosion is the process by which particles that are within an earthen structure find their way because of seepage forces to an exit point.
We really don't have a good way to detect internal erosion really at all. It's basically just using indicators. And so, you know, the more indicators we can get to kind of guide us to whether or not there might be a problem, the better.
So some of the current tools we're using to detect internal erosion would be observation, so looking for seepage, being on site, looking at where the water's coming out, what color the water is, whether particles are moving or not. We also use settlement points, so we measure the amount of movement in the dam. So if it's settled, obviously we think material's moved. Piezometers, where we're looking at water levels within the dam. Each of these are tools to look at our indicators of internal erosion.
The Army Corps of Engineers is partnering with Reclamation to look at solutions for this problem because the problem bridges their structures and our structures. We're both primary players in managing the national portfolio of dams and levees.
If we were able to detect internal erosion with different forms of technology, that would have a drastic impact on the way monitoring is done at all dams. It would definitely impact the entire industry. It would make people a lot safer. Right now, we don't know what that answer looks like. That's why we're doing and issuing this prize challenge.
We've thrown a lot of things at this, you know. So I think that this is unique because the solution that we're going to get is going to be so far outside of the box that nobody who's been pursuing this problem as their career has even, you know, thought of.
I'm really excited about the prize competitions because I'm hoping that they'll allow us to access solutions that we haven't thought of. In the geotechnical engineering community, we've been thinking about this problem pretty hard for a while. We have some ways to try to solve the puzzle, but very much a puzzle. So hopefully with the prize competition, somebody can come to the table with a new piece to the puzzle that might make things a little bit easier, or maybe a little bit quicker, a little more reliable for us to determine whether there's a problem so that we can determine whether we need a solution.